reports of violence from Northern Ghana. And I think this is what we can do also in our various newsrooms here in Ghana. For example, you may have your regional correspondent who is an all-around. When he brings in a report, be it sports or something, then you can have one person who is a specialist in that particular field. Maybe you can have somebody, a specialist in financial reporting, a specialist in court reporting or parliamentary correspondent, who will have to have maybe somebody who has a very good understanding of some of these processes, you know, the institutions, the nature of the issues that are cross-cutting. And then, you know, all you need is to put it into perspective for your audience. And I think in Africa, when we talk of specialization, I think this is the key for us. We don't need to turn every reporter into a specialist, but at least we can have a cadre or a hub of at least good journalists within in-house that are able to comment, that are able to report on some of these issues, you know, with a specialist mind, from a perspective of a specialist. For example, if we are talking about an extractive industry, Revenue Watch sponsors a journalist to do an investigation on, say, Galamsey, in somewhere in the Upper East region, where I just came from, you know, doing some reports, series of reports on river blindness, you know, which everybody thought is eliminated, but, you know, it's still wreaking havoc in there. So you should be able to have somebody who should be in the, you know, in the house there to be able to put perspective on this. Why are young people going into this Galamsey? What are the issues? What are the problems? You know, so this is for me, is because I have just finished a three-year project funded by the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, in which we were building capacity for African community radios and, you know, journalists to be able to, one, specialize and then also, you know, report on some of these cross-cutting development issues, you know, in a very strategic, professional way. And we can learn a thing or two from this kind of things. You cannot turn everybody or an entire institution into specialists, but you can focus on key reporters who, you know, if you train them, you track them for a specific period of time, they will be able to report on these things professionally, and then, you know, give a professional perspective into some of these things. The other thing also is that specialization in any newsroom is very expensive. Okay, and as someone said here, our newsrooms are too small. You know, we have a very small audience in terms of even circulation of our newspapers. So anything that will, you know, force the newspaper to spend more time and resources on one story will definitely be found out. So, you know, you can have few reporters who will report on this, and then you have your key specialist in the newsroom who will be able to report on these things and then bring out the perspectives. And then you will see the flow. And this also brings another serious issue that is lacking in our newsrooms, collaboration to do a story. Many a time you visit our newsrooms, we are all engaged in our small little things, and you know, when you write the report, this is not even an informed opinion. You know, much more a very good, you know, perspective. So I think we should start thinking about you know, the management structure of our newsrooms, the management structure of our news organizations, you know, start thinking about, you know, capacity building, you know, in a targeted way, so that one, they are sustainable and not a resource burden on the media institutions themselves.
Thank you.